Types of foundations in building design. Foundations in buildings are a major part of a structure that serves as a base to the columns and walls from which the overall weight of the structure transmit. They then transfer the full load of the structure into the underlying soil. Foundations are usually made of a reinforced concrete material specifically designed according to its uses. To decide which foundation is best suited for your design, it is important for the structural engineer to differentiate each of the types of foundations. This video aims to understand each type of foundation and for you to eventually manage the appropriate foundation in your design. In structural engineering world, there are two common categories of foundations in building design. Namely, shallow foundations and deep foundations. 1. Shallow foundations. The shallow foundations normally range from 1 meter to 3 meters deep from the natural grade level. They are more economical than deep foundations, since a lesser volume of excavation is required because shallow foundations normally rest in hard strata that are located just near the ground surface. The types of shallow foundations are isolated footing. Isolated footing is the most common and widely used type of foundation. It is usually shaped as a square, rectangular or even circular pad of concrete that used to support an individual column. It is a perfectly suited choice for light structures like residential and medium-story buildings having columns that are not closely spaced at each other. Combined footings. Combined footings are used to support more than one column. This is applicable when columns are so close together, where making isolated bases to them creates overlapping configurations. In designing a combined footing, it is important that the centroid of the footing coincides with the centroid of the two combined loads. In this way, the soil-bearing pressure underneath the footing will spread uniformly to prevent uneven soil settlements. Strap footing. This type of foundation is also known as cantilever or neighbor footings, composed of two isolated footings. Concentric and eccentric, that is connected with a strap beam. This footing is best suited when a column is near a property line and due to space restriction, an eccentric footing is necessary. To even the distribution of the soil-bearing pressure, a strap beam is made to tie it with the neighboring, or closed column having a concentric footing. The strap should be designed as a rectangular beam spanning between the two columns. The width of the strap beam is normally equal to the width of the largest column plus 100 mm and its depth is determined according to the maximum bending moment. The main reinforcement of strap beam is placed on the top, with the links or stirrups placed near the support. Bottom reinforcement may also be needed to resist the settlement stresses. Strip footing. A strip footing is composed of a continuous base that usually supports a retaining wall. It can also be applicable to use when there are multiple columns aligned vertically or horizontally that are closely spaced at each other. This is economical to use when using numbers of isolated footings for closely spaced column overlaps. Designing a strip footing manually considers 1 meter strip with the highest column or wall load to be applied. Otherwise, structural software like Safe is also applicable to use to account for any top or bottom additional bars. Raft or mat foundation. The raft foundation, also known as mat footing, is a single thick foundation that uses to support the entire weight of the structure. This type of foundation is used where a column load is too heavy and when a soil-bearing capacity is too low. The raft foundation can be used for 12 to 16-story buildings or higher and those structures having basements provided that the soil-bearing pressure can withstand the bearing pressure resulting from the overall load of the structure. 2. Deep foundations. When the soil's hard strata are too deep for excavation, deep foundation is necessary. These types are normally found and best suited in areas where there are inadequate or low soil-bearing capacities, with higher water tables, having excessive soil settlements and technically those areas with naturally soft soils. The types of deep foundation are driven piles. Driven piles are used to be driven into the ground using vibro hammer or equivalent machines. They are composed of either concrete precast piles and steel H-beam or tubular steel pile having the capacities of 3000 kN to 800 kN. Though this type is cheap and easy to install, we need to consider the pile head damages and shaft bending during the driving. Noise and vibration control is also a challenge when using this pile and it is not recommended for soils that naturally had boulders or rocks. Mini piles. Mini piles are smaller in diameter board piles that are used in confined spaces and poor access that can support up to 1000 kilonewtons load. They are usually composed of 0.3 meters diameter and uses smaller rigs, usually less than 2 meters high. Continuous flight auger. CFA does not need casings or support fluid during the installation as the construction is relatively a fast pace. Simultaneous drilling and concreting of the drilled soil have to take place almost at the same time. After the drilled area was filled with fresh concrete, a pre-arranged reinforcing cage is placed immediately and pushed down to the fresh concrete. Board piles. Perhaps the most common type of deep foundation in building construction is the use of board piles. Pre-drilling is used according to locations of the pile holes. A casing and bentonite system is necessary for borehole stabilization. Board piles are then casted underneath with pile caps. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more.